Today's edition of News 6 is brought to you by Whirlpool Corporation, Findlay Division, and by the Northwest Ohio Educational Technology Foundation.
Today on News 6, we'll take a look at the art of doll making. We'll examine a different family business. And we'll meet a man with a dazzling hobby. Hi and welcome back to News 6. I'm Kathy Gaspin from Deshler Elementary School in Deshler, Ohio. Here with our first story is Tammy Huffman.
Martin Panning once had a bright idea to build his own stained glass lamp. It's still a shining example of his hobby of working with stained glass.
There are many hobbies in this world, but one of the most interesting has to be creating stained glass works. Martin Panning, a Deshler resident, has spent the last 6 years making lamps, jewelry boxes, and parrots from different colored forms of glass. How did you get started working with stained glass?
I got started in stained glass when I retired from a job and sort of wanting something to do during my leisure time during the winter months, and I was kind of fascinated with stained glass.
There are several tools needed to work with stained glass. First, a glass cutter is used to cut glass from a pattern obtained from a hobby store. After a piece of glass is cut out, the glass edges are smoothed with a grinder. Separate pieces of glass are then glued together using solder and a soldering iron. It takes much time and patience to put together a fine-crafted stained glass art piece, but you can see the final project is well worth the wait.
The show is produced by Sue Priggy and Diane Williams, 6th grade classes from Deshler Elementary School in Deshler, Ohio. Deshler is located in Henry County, about 15 miles southwest of the city of Bowling Green. The town was incorporated in 1876 and its present population is around 1,900 people. Now here's Kevin Rosebrook, who will baby you with our next story.
Most dolls in the market today are made of plastic, but not so long ago, most dolls were made of porcelain. Janet Teal still makes dolls the old-fashioned way, from porcelain.
We've all seen toy stores with thousands of dolls that either cry, laugh, burp, or wet. Janet Teal of McClure, Ohio, actually makes her own dolls. But these dolls are special, a throwback to the past. Janet's dolls are made of porcelain. Janet showed us what she goes through to make a porcelain doll. Janet first purchases the different sections of the doll, the head, body, arms, and feet from a ceramic shop. These doll sections are called greenware. After returning home, Janet takes an X-Acto knife and gently scrapes the seams from the greenware. She must be careful because porcelain breaks easily. From there, Janet cleans the greenware with first a nylon sock, then a cotton ball to smooth the greenware surface. Janet then places greenware in a kiln, a special oven used for hardening the greenware. The temperature is set for almost 2,700 degrees and the doll figures bake for 6 to 8 hours. After the greenware cools, Janet sands the porcelain so that China paint can stick to the dowel surface better. China paint is a special paint mixture that makes the dowel figures look more natural. Janet then assembles the dowel parts together, makes the dowel clothing, and voila, a beautiful porcelain dowel. As for me, I'd rather have a porcelain dowel than a dowel who burps or wets its pants any day.
Now it's time for Kids View, a weekly feature in which kids get to say what's on their minds. This week's question is, who is your favorite movie or TV star? And it was submitted by Brian Parker. Here's what you had to say.
My favorite movie star is Eddie Murphy because he's funny.
My favorite movie star is Richard Pryor because he's funny.
My favorite movie star is Sylvester Stallone because he's active.
I really like Ricky Schroeder because he's a good actor.
My favorite TV actor is Clint Eastwood because he's awesome.
I like Bob Newhart because his style of acting makes the show funny.
My favorite actor is Jerry Lewis because he makes me laugh.
I like Don Johnson with my advice because he's cute.
Chuck Norris is my favorite movie star because he's good at martial arts.
I like Michael J. Fox because he's funny and good looking.
I like Arnold Schwarzenegger because he's got muscles like me.
Bulk food stores are a new rage in grocery shopping. A bulk food store just opened in Deshler. It's called the Kitchen Cupboard. Let's take a look.
Not too many small towns have large businesses. Deshler, Ohio is no different, but it does have the Kitchen Cupboard, a family-owned bulk food store owned by Linda Babcock and her husband, Richard. Exactly what is the Kitchen Cupboard?
Kitchen Cupboard is a small bulk food store in a small town, which makes it a little bit different than the big bulk food stores you would find in the larger cities. In order for us to be a specialty shop, we don't really have to have a lot of special things. We just have to have a little bit more of a variety than you might find in your local grocery store.
How is your family involved with the business?
We wanted something that would include the whole family. That was one of the major reasons that I decided that I'd like to start a business in town, not so much as a total way of living, earning a living, but as a supplement to my husband's income and something that would involve all of us. I had to be practical about it and think of something that would support itself in this town. A used bookstore, when I looked into that, the inventory was quite high. As opposed to that, we could start this store with much lower inventory. We're very lucky to be situated this close to a port city, which is one reason we're able to buy the fruits and nuts at such a reasonable cost. One of the advantages of shopping in a small shop like this instead of a regular grocery store is the size of package that you can purchase. If they only need 2 ounces of something, I'll gladly weigh that up for them. I found out that it is really pleasant to work here. It's pleasant having the people stop in. They're all very nice. I haven't had a cranky customer yet.
So, if buying bulk food is your kind of bag, stop by and visit Linda at the Kitchen Cupboard.
That's all for this week's show. We hope to see you again on News 6 real soon.
Today's edition of News 6 is brought to you by Whirlpool Corporation, Findlay Division, and by the Northwest Ohio Educational Technology Foundation.